In this tutorial, I will show you how you can use mail hooks inside IntegraMod. Mail hooks are really cool. You can use them to process emails automatically inside your scenario. And you can also use them to automatically process any attachments that those emails have. So let's just dive right in and then I'll show you everything about it. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is we're going to create a mail hook module so that I can explain how it works. So we have this new scenario over here and we want to add a mail hook module as a start trigger so that whenever the mail hook gets new data, the scenario is going to start. So to do that, we just click this module over here. Then you go to the webhooks module. If you cannot find it, you can also just always search here. You just type it in and then here it says webhooks. Then you go over here and then you see that we have two different triggers. So we have a custom mail hook and we have a custom webhook. Custom webhooks are also really cool. Be sure to check out this tutorial if you want to learn more about that. But now we're focusing on the custom mail hook. So you just click this over here and then you can select a mail hook that you maybe already created, or you can add a new one if you did not do that yet. So I'm going to call this one example 0. Then I click here, save, and then you see that we get a really long email address. So you see here that we have all these characters, and then here at hook.integramod.com. So this is our mail hook address. I copy that now, then I click here, okay. Then I click save, and then to just demonstrate what it looks like if it receives data, I click here, run this module only. So now it's waiting till it's receiving data. Then I go over to my inbox, I compose a new email, and I will call this one test, hey, hey, and then I click send. Then we go back over here and then we quickly wait till the email is there. And then you see that we got that data. So we click this and then here you see that we got one bundle, one email, and this was the date the email was received. This was the subject of the email, the text inside the email, the HTML content of the email, and then also who sent the email, who the email was intended for. So in this case, the email address is the IntegraMod mail hook. Then the copy recipients, blind copy recipients. Then if there's any attachments, that will also show up over here. I will show you that in a bit. And then the headers. This is a little bit more taggy. I will not go too deep on this right now, but we especially want to focus on this over here. And then what is so cool is that you can use all this data in your next modules. So maybe let's say we want to add the person who sent this email to maybe a Google Sheet, for example. Then real simple, what we do is we say, go to another module. Then we search for Google Sheet. Then we go to add a row. Then we wait for this to load. Then here, select spreadsheet and sheet. And then I want to select this one, example sheet list of people. Then the sheet is this one, sheet one. Does it contain headers? Headers inside the Google Sheet is always here in the first row. So in this case, A is name, B is email, C is note, and D is date. So then you see that those show up over here, your A, B, C, D, E, right? And then with those names. And then we can just select in here, and then we can select the variables from our mail hook. So here, name, like for example, you go to sender, and then I say here, okay, name. Then I add the email address. Now note, I will just leave that blank. And then maybe I also want to add the date that it is sent. And what I like to do, you do not have to do that, but you can also format that date to any format you want. So I want to format it to the day, month, year. So to do that, I go over to this little calendar. Then I say here, format date. Then I go back to the star. I put my cursor in here. I say here, date. And then I use tokens. So tokens you can find over here. And by the way, I also have a whole separate tutorial that you can check out over here if you're curious about how this works. So then I want the day of the month, I want the month number, and I want to have the year. So to do that then, I do dd slash mm slash yyyy. And then I click OK. And then I click Save. Then I click run once so that we can test it again. So to test it, we have to send another email. So I paste the email address in here. Then here I call this test2. And then we do hello there. And then we click send. Then we go back over to our scenario. And then you see that it received the data. So here you see test2, hello there. Then it continued to the next module, to our Google Sheet module. And then if we go over here now, you see here emma.doe@gmail.com. We did not add a note. And then here today's date. So pretty simple, right? Now then I want to show you another example, and that is this one. And it's just to show you that you can maybe have one mail hook and then do multiple things with that mail hook. So you just have your mail hook here over here, and then it continues after it's receiving data, right? And then what you can do is you can add a router, and a router allows you to split your flows into multiple routes. So here you see we have, for example, invoices. So then what you could, for example, do is you could say, okay, I want to set a condition. The subject should contain case insensitive invoice. So then if the mail hook gets an email that the subject has in it, in the subject invoice, then it will continue down this path. And then maybe you want to add it to like your bookkeeping software, something like that, right? Or maybe you get sometimes emails that have like certain praise, like people that say like, hey, I love your content. I enjoy your tutorials. Your emails are so helpful, something like that. Then maybe what you want to do is you want to check the text that was inside the email. So if it contains maybe love or like your or helpful, then it is going to continue to this path. And then maybe you want to store that in another Google Sheet or something. And then you can maybe also create a fallback. So here you said a sheet that I called this everything else. So here I said, okay, this is the fallback route. So I checked this box. So everything that cannot continue over here or over here will continue over here. And then maybe you can do something else. But then now, how can you deal with attachments? Is a little bit more complicated, but also really not that hard. So I created this example over here. I'm going to delete this and then we quickly just make this again so that you can really see step by step how this works. So here again, we go to webhooks, we go to custom mail hook, then we click add. Then here I call this example 5, for example, save. Then I get here the webhook or the mail hook URL. And then maybe I want to upload all the attachments to a Google Drive folder. So I created a Google Drive folder over here. So you see here, my drive, order, and then email attachments. I want to add all the email attachments I get into this folder, for example. So then to do that, what we do is we add a Google Drive module. And then you just say here, upload a file. Now then here, enter folder ID, select from list, then select the location, then I click over here, and then we want to look for order, and then for email attachments, and that's where I want to store it. And then you see here that's asking for the source file, so we need to add the file name and the data. So what I like to do then is we go over here to attachments, then you can click this little drop down, and then you see here file name, and then also data. So then it's just copying one-on-one the name and all the data, and we'll upload that over there. So then we click here OK, we click here Save, we click Run once. Then I go over to my inbox, then we go to Compose, we send an email to that new mail hook, and I'll call this invoice for Max, for example. Here is your invoice. And then we add an attachment. We add the invoice as an attachment, so it's a PDF. Then we click Send. Then it's the message is sent. We go back over to our scenario. And then you see that the email was received. Then it uploaded it. So you see here, this is the email that we got. Invoice for Max. Here is your invoice. And then if you go down here to attachments, you see that here now there's like a little one. So there's one array. There's one attachment. And then you also see the type. So it's a PDF. And then this is the data of this PDF. So then we go to the next module and then you see that it was uploaded. So then we go over here and then you see right now that we have our example invoice. So pretty cool, but there is one problem with this. Because what if, for example, an email would have multiple attachments? Then in this case, it's only going to upload the first attachment. So if you expect emails with multiple attachments, then you have to add an iterator. And an iterator basically allows you to split kind of like your scenario into like lots of little bundles so that every PDF or every other attachment is going to be uploaded separately. So to do that, we click here, unlink, then we go over here and then you type in flow control. Then we go over here, then we click here, iterator. Then you also see this icon. So here, one thing goes in, multiple things come out. And then we have the array. The array are the attachments. We click here OK, and we connect it over here. We click a little magic wand so that it looks nice again. We go over here, and then instead of mapping the file name and the data separately, we say here source file, and then we just select our iterator. We click here OK, we click save, we click run once, and then now when we send an email, lots of attachments. Hey Max, here is an awesome email. And then here I add attachments, and then I add two attachments. I click here OK. Then before I click send, I quickly delete this one, otherwise you cannot see that it works. And then I click send. Then we wait for the message to arrive. So then you see that we've got the email, the iterator did his work, and now the files are uploading. And then you can also see over here, if you go here to attachments, that we have a one and a two. So here we have two different attachments. Then the iterator basically split them. And then here you see that we have over here like once in the circle, right? And here two. So here it did like one thing, and here it uploaded two things. So now when we go over here, you see that it uploaded both things. So yeah, this is how the mail hooks work. So you simply create the mail hook module, you have an email address, and then whenever that email address is receiving data, then your scenario is going to start. And then you can, for example, upload something to a Google Sheet. Maybe you want to do multiple things, then you can use a route to like split your scenario into multiple routes. And then if you want to upload attachments, then you can just simply use maybe a Google Drive module. But then if you expect multiple attachments, then you want to make sure to use an iterator. Now, if you have any questions, then just post it in the comments below, and then I'll try to help you as best as I can. And like I said before, I also created a really cool tutorial about webhooks that I also think are really, really handy. So be sure to check that out over here.